So in this video we will see how to solve someone trapezoidal cross section curved beam. So here is a curved beam of trapezoidal cross section as given. So the dimensions of the longer side is 18, shorter side is 6, and the depth of the beam is 40. So it is subjected to load of 5000 N. So in the same section is enlarged below here. The longer side is 18, shorter side 6, and the depth is 40 mm. So similarly, the previous sum we have the force axis, so the neutral axis, centroidal axis, and the center line of curvature. So from the figure, it is given that RI, the radius of the inner fiber, is 25 mm. So directly RI is 25 mm. R naught is radius of outer fiber. So how is it from R naught? So R naught is measured as RI plus the depth of the beam. That is RI plus 40. So it is 25 plus 40. That is 65. So that is the value of R naught. So next, to find the RN value, we need to refer the data handbook. That is volume 2. So the equation number is 25.62. It's curve beam chapter. So here is the trapezoidal cross section for which you have the RN formula, that is radius of neutral axis. So substituting these parameters we have the answer of 38.8175 mm as the value of RN. So next our goal is to find the value of C1 and C2, that is to locate the centroidal axis in a trapezoidal cross section beam. So this is done by referring data handbook volume 1, so that is table 2.7 in volume 1, so where you have the trapezoidal cross section. So the distance C, whatever is here, is measured from the shorter side of the beam. Okay, so the distance to the farthest point C, so formula is given, h by 3 into 3b plus 2b naught divided by 2b plus B naught. So keeping this formula, we find the distance. So since it is from the shorter side, so here the shorter side, so it becomes C2. So whatever value of C we are finding, that is nothing but C2 in this diagram. So C2 we have it as 24 mm. So C1 is nothing but the total depth minus the value of C2. So I get it as 16 mm. So RC is nothing but RI plus the value of C1. So C1 plus RI will give me the value of RC. So E is the eccentricity, that is the difference between RC minus RN. So that is given by 2.18 mm. So CI is RN minus RI from the figure. So C0 is R0 minus R. So to find the area of trapezium, always remember area of trapezium is given by half into sum of the parallel sides. The parallel sides here are the 18 mm and 16 mm, and the perpendicular distance between them, so that is the h. So half into sum of parallel sides, that is 24, into the distance between them, that is 40, is equal to 480 mm square. So next we are going to find the direct stress, so this is nothing but the ratio of force by area. So force is 5000, area is 480 as found. So we get a tensile stress of 10.4 newton per mm square. Next, we are going to calculate the value of MB, that is the bending moment. So that is nothing but force into the distance. The distance is measured between the centroidal axis and the force line. So clearly from the diagram, it is 100 plus the value of RC. So RC plus 100. So substituting these values, we will have the value of MB. So sigma BI is given by, that is the bending stress at inner fiber, is given by MBCI by AERI, so which is tensile in nature. So sigma B naught is MBC naught by AER naught. So due to the applied force, so there is a tendency for outer fiber to compress. So that is why it is compressive stress at the outer fiber, and at the inner fiber the fiber tends to expand due to the applied load 5000 N. So it is tensile in nature. So next we will see how to find the resultant stress and plot the stress distribution curve for this sum. Okay, so say we have a sigma RI, that is the resultant stress at inner fiber. So So the value of sigma r is given by adding up the direct stress plus bending stress at inner fiber. So it is 10.417 plus 286. So we get answer of 296.65, which is tensile in nature. So next we are going to find the resultant stress at outer fiber. So that is done by adding the direct stress plus bending stress at outer fiber. So the bending stress at outer fiber remains compressive in nature, so it is with a negative sign. So we get minus 198 as the answer, which is in compressive in nature. So see the magnitude. So compare the magnitude of values between sigma r and sigma r naught. So the greater number between these two values divide by 2 will give me the maximum shear stress. So the greater between these two values is by magnitude, it is 296.65 divided by 2, it is 148. So where does this exist? This exists at the inner fiber. So it is tensile in nature and exists at the inner fiber. So finally we see how to plot a stress distribution curve for the curved beam. So the draw the curved beam with the centroidal axis and neutral axis marked. Okay, so next we have the direct stress, which has to be plotted first. So the direct stress, so since it is tensile in nature and positive, so it should be marked above zero line. So it is same throughout the cross section of the beam. So next we will be plotting the bending stress at outer fiber and inner fiber. So the bending stress at outer fiber remains compressive in nature, so it is below the zero line. So while at the neutral axis the stress becomes zero, so that is what we have studied. Okay, so for a curved beam, the neutral axis the stress is zero, stress remains zero at the neutral axis. So the bending stress at inner fiber tends to be tensile, so it is on the positive side of, that is above zero line. Okay, in the similar fashion we plot the resultant stress at outer fiber and resultant stress at inner fiber like this. Note that this is a curve, it is not a straight line, because it is hyperbolic stress distribution in case of a curved beam. So thank you.